What's one unusual or unique thing about you that people would never guess?
Probably that I'm actually come from a very large family. I'm one of 11 children, so I basically grew up in this tiny little house, and then I shared a bedroom with a bunch of brothers.
Must have been a very loud house.
It was very loud, especially when the girls would fight.
Hi, Dave Mooney.
Oh, hello.
Can I ask you a few questions?
Sure.
Where are we right now?
We're at the Wyss Institute at Harvard University, where we are working to both invent and then translate new technologies to help people.
What is your favorite breakfast food?
Cold cereal with skim milk.
Is that what you had this morning?
Yes, every morning.
Can you describe yourself in three words?
Focused, driven, and patient. Although my wife, I think, would disagree with the patient part.
So you said you grew up in the United States. Where exactly did you grow up?
Yeah, I grew up in Madison, Wisconsin.
And what's one thing you miss about it?
Probably the friendliness of the people. I love Boston, but people here are not quite as friendly as in the Midwest.
What is the best piece of advice you've ever received?
So once you've made a decision, you don't turn around and look back at the doors that are closing behind you, but instead you focus on all the new opportunities that now exist in front of you once you've made that decision.
What accomplishment are you most proud of?
Raising my two sons and being married to my wife for the last 32 years is my greatest accomplishments. Professionally, I'd say all the students and fellows and staff that I've had the opportunity to work with, train and mentor, and both their accomplishments in the lab and then since they've left the lab.
Can you show me something awesome?
Sure, yeah, right over here. We've developed these very small particles, these microparticles that are in orange in this image. And then they're interacting with T cells, and T cells are these blue blobs here. And these particles act as artificial cells, and they activate the T cells and cause them to expand. So this technology is now being used by a company to manufacture T cells for therapies for patients who suffer from cancer. And we're continuing to use this technology in the laboratory to better understand how T cells get activated and are effective at killing cancer so we can develop kind of the next generation of therapies in this space.
Wow, that is awesome. Thank you so much. We'll let you get back to your very important work.
My pleasure.